My master. Safe. The scriptures. Sound. All I ever wanted was a life in my mountain, free from you and your so-called merits. Those high above don't trust me. I understand that. And they send you and those knuckleheads to threaten me. To obey and serve once more. I understand that too. But what I don't understand is... You bastards killing my kind!
Mark this. He's not just any monkey. He's a monkey of merit. A monkey was made Buddha once. None other than me can challenge him to a duel. Look, monkey. I don't make a habit of fighting someone I've bested before. Here's my offer. If you lose, I'll take you to the Celestial Court. They will stay and level your mountain. But if I lose, I shall certainly take revenge, and they will level your mountain nonetheless. How tragic would that be, huh? You are one of the court. We don't need to resort to violence. How about you bend the knees, admit the wrongs, and we can put this behind us?
All these years, except for that pig. You're the one who talks the tallest tales. Good, I am entertained. Speaking of entertainment, wouldn't it be fun if I pluck your extra eye out for my snack and allow you to keep the other two? Because I'd hate to let you miss how I'll slaughter each mongrel of the court. Those below, those above, and that black mutt of yours. Come at me, all of you!
They gave you many chances. You spurned each one. Such ingratitude. Fighting Buddha. Have you any idea how many would give their everything for immortality?
Immortality? For that word, all realms and beings have ruined themselves.
Treasured his freedom above all else. Buddhahood he attained, yes, but cumbersome he found the celestial rules, for he yearned to come back and to revel in the simple joys with us. Little did he know, his choice to forgo the life above only fueled their mistrust. This stone has stood stood for countless days on the mountain. Since my youth, they've said that his remains lie within it. Unbegotten, undying, such is the nature of a stone monkey. Though his body was broken, his spirit endures. Into six relics he turned, and separately they escaped, choosing to stay hidden. Those are the six senses of the great sage. Yet no one has ever seen them. Not in centuries. I'm old now. Venture through all the lands, I cannot. Yet among you, there might be one who is destined. One that shall recover all his scattered relics. And upon the return of the relics to Mount Tuago, he may yet rise again.
On the gold bend, the toll, life of human or for gold.
Nowhere better than a home. We cheat death and ever grow.
Huh?
Yeah, you see. What bliss my fate
shows. Well, luck's around the corner. Seems like you just fell from a fruit tree here.
Perfect timing. This peach knew I needed a snack. You sneaky rascal! Dare to fool me? I'll make sure you regret it!
As mischievous as ever, eh?
哎呀，发什么呆？拔个毛来拜一拜。 是黑风山的土地，在此候你多时。真像，真像。再往前走，就是观音禅院，当年也是香火鼎盛，只可惜。 那场大火哟，后来呀，这禅院又被重建了，可人心若是烧没了，修好一座破庙，又有什么用呢？ 许久不用，没成想这定身术倒还好使。即使画过山来的故人，教你一招也无妨。来，速速把手伸来。 写好了，日后遇到什么凶匪恶徒，只需要用着手一指，心里默念一声“定”，就能让对方动弹不得。你也可喘息片刻，只是小老儿道行浅薄，这定身效果不消片刻就会失灵。遇到些笨货倒还好用。
你全当是挣个傍身的手段吧。如今这些小儿真是目无尊长，别怕，用刚学的法术与他玩玩。 上不堪用。